Dear students, today we will discuss about batteries. There are two types of batteries: primary and second is secondary. Primary battery is that which cannot be recharged. It cannot be recharged. If it is used once, it cannot be used again. And the secondary battery is that which can be recharged again and again. The pencil cell used in wall clock is a primary battery, because as it is, once it is used, it is consumed, it cannot be recharged. But the battery used in mobile phone can be recharged again and again, so it is secondary battery. So there are two types of batteries: primary battery, which cannot be recharged, and secondary battery, which can be recharged again and again. Now, charging a battery, how we can charge a battery? When you charge a battery, you are forcing the electron backwards. To do this, you will need a higher voltage backward than forward. This is why the emitter in your car often goes slightly higher while your battery is charging, and then returns to normal. In your car, the battery charger is called as alternator. If you have a dead battery, it could be the battery need to be replaced, or the alternator is not charging the battery properly. So when we are charging a battery, we are reversing the reaction taking place in that battery. So if the reaction is reversible, then a battery can be recharged. So in primary battery, the cell reaction is not reversible. Now, the first battery which we are studying is a dry cell Leclanche cell, and it is a primary battery. It is consist of a zinc container which acts as anode, and a graphite rose is fitted at the middle of this cell, which acts as cathode, where zinc chloride and ammonium chloride are taken as electrolytes, surrounded by a layer of MnO2. So first thing, you don't need to mug up that which one is anode and which one is cathode. You just think that if any cell there is free metal, like in this battery Zn, we are having Zn. You know that the electrode where oxidation takes place is called anode. Now, a metal is the only substance which can release electron, which can undergo oxidation. So if a cell is containing anywhere a free metal, certainly it will form anode. So in this case, the zinc container acts as anode and graphite rod acts as cathode. At anode, zinc releases 2 electrons and forms Zn+2, where at cathode is surrounded by ammonium chloride, so there are 2 ammonium ions surrounded by MnO2, 2 plus 2 electrons which are released at anode and travels to cathode, and we will get 2 ammonia, water and Mn2O3. Overall, cell reaction can be written as this. Now, this is the dry cell, which is a primary cell. Mercury cell, it is also a primary cell used in wristwatch. In this cell, there is zinc container. Again, the zinc container is made up of a particular metal, free metal. So we know that oxidation can take place only at anode. So the free metal will release electron and act as anode. Cathode is made up of steel, where potassium hydroxide and paste of zinc hydroxide and HgO are taken as cathode. Anode, zinc reacts with potassium hydroxide and gives ZnO S2N+2 electrons, where at cathode, HgO S2O plus 2 electron, Hg plus 2OH minus, and we will get the final cell reaction, overall cell reaction like this. So these are the primary batteries.